Hello, and welcome back to another exciting episode of Game On, our show for game developers. I'm your host, Todd Kerpelman. I know it's been a while since our last episode, and I've missed you. Did you do something different with your hair? It looks nice. Anyway, this episode is all about not shipping broken games, or I guess to put a more positive spin on it, testing your game for fun and profit, mostly profit. And it's all done through the magic of using Google Play's alpha and beta services to get your game out in front of a large audience before you publish. So I'd like to start today by telling you a little story about Don. See, Don is a game developer, and he just released the very first version of his hotly anticipated game to the world. He was so excited, he could barely sleep that night. And so when he woke up the next morning, the first thing he did was go out and check his app's review page, which looked a little something like this. Huh. What happened? Well, Don did some digging around, and he found out that due to a font rendering error, the game crashed for any player who had an E in their name. Well, Don immediately got together with his team members, Alicia Winkowski, Erwin Lin, and Chris Fulbright, and said, "How do we miss this? How could we have possibly overlooked something as completely obvious as, okay, wait, I think I see it, none of us have an E in our name, that's kind of a problem." And that's when he thought, maybe we should have tested this with a bigger group of people before we launched this thing. But of course, that sets up its own share of problems, right? How are you going to be sharing your game with several dozen friends and family members? Are you going to be like mailing APKs around? How are you going to make sure that only these people have access? How are you going to make sure that they're looking at the latest version? Do you have to like mail them and bug them each time you update and hope that they then download and re-sideload your APK? Come to think of it, how are you going to teach your non-technical users how to sideload an APK in the first place? It can be a bit of a mess. And that brings us to one of the best features of the Play Store publishing process that some of you are overlooking, which frankly is a real shame because it was built for just this situation. And that is our alpha, beta, stage rollout process, also sometimes known as alpha, beta, canary, because that makes for a better looking acronym. This lets you easily test out new apps and app updates with large groups of people before you publish to the world. So let's see what this process looks like. Now, in the past, you're probably used to just uploading your APK to production, where it gets published to the Play Store and is available to the world, and hooray, there's pixie dust. Or, I suppose, if things go badly, oh my god, everything's on fire, run! It's one of the two, not sure. But you don't have to do that, so hang on there, buddy. Stay. You see, the developer console also lets you specify a certain group of people to be your alpha testers. This could be a Google group or a Google Plus community. You know, for example, for my first group of alpha testers, I might want this just to be the employees in my organization. So I could publish, so I could define my alpha testers to be this group and then publish my APK just to them. Now, assuming that all goes well and we haven't found any major bugs, I could then create a second group of beta testers, maybe people outside my company, and again, publish my APK just to them next. Kind of similar process as before. Now, as for how this looks to your testers, you're just going to send them a link to a page where they can click on a button to become a tester. And then once they do that, they can download the game from the Play Store just as if it were a completely normal app. No weird sideloading involved. Access is completely handled by your group settings. You can leave it open or invite only, however you want. And you know, all those concerns Don had, they're basically solved. So where do you get these testers? Well, here's one fun example. The developers of Castle Storm promoted their Android program right on their site. So when you went and visited their website, you would see this page. Clicking on this little green Play Now button took you to their Google group, which was open for anybody to join, and they got a ton of great beta testers this way. But don't forget about your Google Plus communities. These are often highly engaged fans of your game, and they'd be really good candidates for beta testers, not only for any new updates to existing games, but also for any new product that you release. And by the way, this is a fantastic way to connect with your community. Getting early feedback on new games or new updates from your most dedicated fans will provide you with some fantastic insight from people who, quite frankly, know your game probably better than you. And it also makes them part of the process and a collaborator in your game, and then they can become your biggest supporters and your biggest advocates in the outside world. Your players, they want your games to be awesome. They're on your side. Don't be afraid to engage with them. However you do it, assuming everything goes well with your beta test group, you can then push your app up to production, and then the world can finally play your game. Now, this is all great, but what happens if you want to update your game? Maybe you've got a round of bug fixes, but you want to make sure this bug fix doesn't accidentally create a whole bunch of bigger bugs in the process. It's been known to happen to some game developers, quite possibly ones in this room giving presentations right now. So, as you might expect, alpha and beta work similar for game updates as well. I can upload a new version of my game to the alpha group, and all my alpha testers, they'll be able to grab the latest version of my app just as if the app had been updated normally for them in the Play Store. In fact, in many situations, your alpha testers, they'll just get the update automatically. And then from there, I can promote my new version of my app to beta, have my beta testers try it out, and then push it onto production, right? Well, wait, stop, stay there one second. See, this time around, for updates to an existing app, there is a shocking twist. Yes, that's right, even our stock image photography model is surprised. You see, instead of just updating my app fully on production, I can do something that's called a staged rollout. What this lets me do is push out the new version of my game to just a small percentage of the market. This is a great way to make extra sure your game is going to work well with a larger audience. It also, it turns out, is a nice way to see what people who aren't your friends and family might think of your game. Turns out your mom might not actually be your most objective customer. Sorry, Mom. So what this means is I can have version 2 of my game out to a small fraction of the world while having version 1 of my game available to everybody else. And then as time goes on and I'm feeling fairly confident about this update, I can expand that rollout more and more and more until the whole world is finally ready to see the update to my game. And the nice thing is that you can see your reviews, your crashes, and your other stats broken out by application version right there in the developer console. So if your players hate your update, you can see that right away in the reviews. More importantly, you can also set up your own analytics to be broken out by version number. So you can see if there are any major problems with retention or ARPDAU or ARPU or any other custom metrics you happen to be tracking. For instance, if we find out that nobody is completing the tutorial in our V2 release, well, that's a sign that something is really wrong there, and we can fix that before we push this update out to the entire population. So this all sounds great, right? Well, with that said, let me address three responses I've heard from developers around alpha beta testing. The first is, well, I'm not sure I want to use this because I don't want to miss the chance to be a top recent game. And let me explain to you what the concern is here. So imagine that you spend a lot of time with your game in alpha and then beta test stages. Then your game hits production here, and that's when it takes off. Well, you know, do we qualify as a top recent game? I mean, we have spent a couple of months in alpha and beta. And it's actually true, we used to start the top recent time here when your game first pushed to alpha, which I think we all agree makes no sense. So you'll be happy to know we now start the top recent timer here once your game has been pushed to production. So if you hear of anybody who's still afraid to alpha test because, you know, they're worried they're going to miss their chance to be on the top recent list, let them know we've addressed this issue, they're working on old info, and they don't need to be concerned about this anymore. And in fact, what I'm also excited to tell you, and go grab your business analyst person and tell them to watch this part, is that we are now calculating the top recent list per country. So if you want to launch your product in, say, Canada first, and then launch 2 weeks later in the US, your top recent window in the US will be determined by the time you first launch there and not in Canada. And so you can launch in different countries at different times and not worry about missing the top recent window elsewhere. See, your business analyst person, they're really excited now, aren't they? They're glad you grabbed them. So a second question I sometimes get is, you know, how do you add achievements or leaderboards or game services, other game services to a version of a game that's in beta? And it turns out these days it's pretty easy. When you create a new leaderboard or achievement or quest or event or what have you in Play Game Services, it remains in an unpublished state on our servers that's only visible to your testers. But if you go into the testers portion of the Play Services developer console, right here, you can see that you can easily add alpha or beta testers as part of the group that has access to these unpublished features on our servers. So if your new APK has, say, a new leaderboard and 5 new achievements, you can simply publish that updated client to your alpha group and then give those same alpha testers access to this new achievement, the new leaderboard and achievements on the server. Your testers get to test these new services out, and then the general public will see this mystery leaderboard or these, you know, mystery achievements that they can't seem to access or unlock. A third question I sometimes get is, okay, so is this what I should be using for A/B testing? And my answer is kind of, sort of, but not really. It depends. Don't be confused by these A/B letters. Alpha beta testing is different than the split testing people sometimes refer to as A/B testing. The point of alpha beta canary testing is really to find out if there are major problems with your game before you launch. Now, you could certainly use it to find out if you've accidentally broken your in-game economy or if some new feature has improved retention. But if you're looking to A/B test small interface changes or gameplay tweaks or, like, you know, the wording that you've put into your purchase dialogue, it's not really best for that. You want your users constantly downloading new APKs and using up their data plan every time you want to test some minor gameplay tweak. So instead, I highly recommend looking at tools like Google Tag Manager, which basically allow you to configure your game and run all the A/B testing you want in the cloud. Google Tag Manager is a really great tool. I am a fan, but I probably don't have time to talk about it here. I'll have to cover that in a future episode. So with all of that in mind, Don, our intrepid game developer, got into his handy-dandy time machine and went back in time to the week before his game launched. This time, instead of just testing his game in-house, he decided to launch it on the beta channel to several dozen of his closest friends. And that's where he found and fixed several other bugs that got missed by his three-person team. With those bugs fixed, he launched his game to great fanfare, the reviews went way up, and just a few months later, his company was acquired for $12 billion. Not because of the game, though, but because of the time machine. Turns out those things, they're really valuable. Anyway, if you are not in the time machine business, but you are in the game business, I'm hoping I've convinced you at this point that alpha beta canary testing is something you should be doing. It's generally pretty easy to get started with. It's all part of the Play Developer Console. But, you know, if you want to see a walkthrough or see me record a screencast or something, let me know in the comments. I'll do that. So that's it for this Game On episode on testing your app. Thanks for tuning in. Test your games with your family, friends, and fans, and let's start seeing some great games out there. Bye.